My brothers, I'm honored that I've been asked to speak to you here on this very special day when you're all released from your home of the past 6 years to go forth and make something of your lives. We fed you, the people of the United States of America. We've clothed you, taken care of your medical needs for the past 6 years in order that when you return to your foreign lands, you can make a contribution to the people of those countries, the Afghanistans, the Pakistans, the Iraqs and Irans, and help bring democracy and justice to those peoples. We hope we've given you a taste, just a small sample of those values during your stay here. We hope you've enjoyed food anyhow. I hope you'll understand that although you may have been frustrated at times with having to stay here, perhaps the extreme temperatures, the separation from your loved ones, the lack of a fair hearing that some of you have complained about, your attorneys rather, that you'll understand that it's all been for your own benefit. Because if you'll recall, when you were rescued from the battlefield by U.S. troops, or by some of our partners in a war against terror, you were serving a shadowy enemy, no doubt against your will, against your better nature, probably in almost all cases recruited by slogans of hate, of mistrust, of hatred for the United States and our system of justice, our goodness, as symbolized by those tall trade towers which you devastated on September 11th. So I think you can understand our outrage and our desire to not only protect ourselves, but to provide a better life for you, so that you no longer feel you have to act in a mean way against us, the United States. I remember when I got my first report on this place, Guantanamo, Gitmo we call it, from the base commander at the time, General Sheldon Shaughnessy. Shorty, I call him. I said, Shorty, General Sheldon, do the foot soldiers, the terrorists, we're taking care of there at Gitmo, do they appreciate what we're doing for them? Do they understand that underneath all that frustration, all that rage, we're really just trying to help them and help the people of their countries? And you know what Shorty, General Sheldon, said to me? He said, Mr. President, I hope they do. I believe they do, sir. And you know, those words touched me because that is what I believe, that there is always hope. That even a man whose soul has been tortured by terrorist rhetoric, by an irrational hatred of a just God and a just country like ours, the United States, can learn to look into his own heart and see where justice really prevails, where goodness lies, and can learn to take that gift back to his own country and teach love, not hate, peace, not war, and make us all allies in the war of love versus hate, of order versus chaos, of peace versus terror. We hope that when you return to your foreign lands, you will find a level of justice, of medical care, of clean and comfortable clothing, as you have found here. And that if you do not, that you will work tirelessly with the people of your foreign lands, your families, your leaders, to make those changes. Well, I've taken about enough of your time. And by God, it is hot down here. Whew! Just like y'all been complaining about. I'm on my way to Crawford, Texas, down in the southern U.S. I thought it was hot there, but I tell you, it's nothing like this. So we send you forth today with our love, with our appreciation for your dedication, for your desire to serve, which we know is buried in there somewhere. Good luck to y'all, with the best wishes of myself and all the people of my country, the United States of America, headquartered in Washington, D.C. And we hope you'll perhaps think of us now and then. Think of us kindly. God bless y'all. God bless you.